Well, greetings, everybody. So I'm just getting ready to finalize episode 3 here of my train hop to Denver. And, you know, there's basically 3 phases to train hopping. There's getting on the train, there's the train ride itself, and then there's getting off of it. And the 2 most challenging parts are getting on and getting off. And you have little control over either one of those things, as you'll see. But before I go on into the video, as I was getting started, I got word that one of my friends had passed away. And I think I've told everybody over and over that I'm a very lucky man in life. And one of those examples of luck was when I lived in central Nebraska in a small, tiny Polish community. Each community in those areas tended to be groups of immigrants that had settled that area. And Loup City was Polish. And not far from Loup City, which is not too far from Grand Island, was another town called Danbrog, which was Danish. Well, I had started selling internet services in those areas and had started an ISP business as part of my computer sales and electronics company I had there. And one of my customers was Roger Welsch. And Roger was an incredible, you know, he was a celebrity in Nebraska, first of all. But beyond that, just a brilliant, entertaining, fun human being. I so enjoyed getting to know him. And I would go help him on his computer stuff, get his internet set up and whatnot. And he bought computers from me and printers and that kind of thing over the years. So I was fortunate enough to strike up a friendship with Roger, to the point he invited me over and I ate lutefisk with him at Eric's Tavern, drinking Guinness. And oh my God, just the stories he could tell. You know, he's a prolific author, and I think nationally people probably know him most for his work on CBS Sunday mornings doing the Postcard from Nebraska episodes. But there's so much more to Roger than those things. And so it's very sad to see him go. It's just another one of those reminders in life that, you know, that this doesn't last forever. And when this starts happening so goddamn often, you have to face fact. This is your group. I'm in this group, you know? So you begin to feel those pressures of life. You're gonna gotta get some things done, gotta get what you can in, gotta spend the time with the family. So, you know, you just have to focus. And so there's things that are coming into play that I hope I can continue freight hopping as much as I have and all of that, but I'm not sure where that fits in the grand scheme of life. But anyway, I want Roger to be known for what I think is the most incredible aspect of he and his wife Linda. So I put one of those cards in here that links to a documentary, a short documentary, award-winning documentary, about what he did, what he and Linda decided to do, and a bit about what he went through doing what's right. But anyway, I hope that you'll watch it. But, you know, rest in peace, Raj. I consider myself incredibly lucky to have had our paths crossed when they did. Take care. Anyway, on with the video.
California's up there. look. Rangeland.
Cool day. Almost to the point of being uncomfortable. I'm probably gonna have to put my hoodie on, I think, by the time we get all the way into Denver. We just went through Brush, Colorado, and then all of a sudden we stopped here on the main line, which seems very strange to me. But usually it's something besides having been seen. But who knows? We are out in the middle of nowhere, more or less. Well, we started going again. And we went about, I'm going to say, 2 miles, maybe, and stopped again. And I heard the dispatcher say something about maintenance the first time we stopped, and that it would be about an hour, and then there was something about an inspection. And so, I'm not sure what's going on. I hope they're not inspecting us. That wouldn't be good. But, you know, who knows? Maybe I got seen coming through one of these towns. I've been laying low, though. I'm a little too visible on here, so I've been just pretty much relaxing all afternoon. It's good, actually, because I didn't want to get into Denver while it was still completely daylight, broad daylight. And I think now it might be dark by the time we get there. Fingers crossed.
Well, I've seen this before. So now, instead of going picking up speed, we're going very slowly. So I'm going to get packed up. I think I'm about to get pulled off.
Well, I'll be damned. You slow roll for about 3/4 of the train. It's just, you know, made me think even more that they're just rolling by looking at every car. Speed. All of a sudden we picked up speed the way we went. here. And I'm just, first time this train stops, I'm getting off. I'm hoping it stops before the intermodal yard. We'll see, but it's a little too light to be going into the intermodal yard. Thank you.
what do you know? The proverbial hole in the fence.